Students, welcome back again in another passive voice lesson. Well, in my previous lesson you learned passive voice in present tense, and now in this lecture you are going to learn passive voice in past tense, right? So we are going to cover these objectives in this lecture. First, passive voice, the rules of passive voice for simple past tense, past continuous tense, past perfect and past perfect continuous tense. And after that we will try to understand the passive voice through various examples related with these tense. Okay. Now first we will understand what is passive voice. In my first lecture you have learned what is a passive voice. Now I am going to repeat again. When the verb in a sentence shows that the subject is not the doer of the action. In another words, we can say that when the subject receives the action of the verb. Okay. So now we will follow the same steps that you have learnt in present tense. The subject becomes object and object becomes subject. And verb goes in past participle form. So first you have to remember that you do not change the tense. You do not change the meaning of sentence. And of course, you do not change the doer of the action. Now students, before starting the passive voice, we will see the rules of the past tense. So in simple past, what we do, we have to put first object and then use of was and were. And after that we will put past participle and then we will have to put by subject. Okay. Now in past continuous tense, we will first place object and then use of was and were. And then after that we will put being, and then after that we will put past participle and then by subject. Okay. Students, in past perfect tense, what we do, we have to put object first because object becomes subject, and then we will use had, then past participle form and then by subject. And in past perfect continuous tense, actually in past perfect continuous tense there is no passive form. Now let's take an example of past simple tense. The boy prepared a science model. Well, this sentence, as you can see, it is in a past simple tense, right? Now, let's ask a question. Who is doing the action or who is the doer of the action? So here, the boy is doing a action. So, in this sentence, the boy will be the subject. Okay? Now, what is the action? Prepared. The prepared will be the verb. What the boy prepared? A science model. So, it is an object here. A science model will be the object here. So, students, remember that we learnt object is the person or thing on which action is done upon. Right? So, this is your object. A science model. Now let's quickly, we have to interchange it. You have object becoming subject. So subject here, a science model. It is becoming a subject here, a science model. And the boy is a subject. It will become by the boy. Okay, become subject. Subject, the boy is a subject. So it will become the object. So by the boy. Okay, now we will see the main verb. Main verb is here prepared. It is already in third form, so it will remain same. Now students, to keep it in the past tense, do not forget to add the supporting verb. Why do we need a supporting verb? Because it helps you to identify the sentence, whether it is a past simple tense or past continuous tense, past perfect or past perfect continuous tense. So we will see here a science model. It is already in a singular form. So was is used. Now the sentence is completed. A science model was prepared by the boy. Okay. Now students, you can see that you have maintained the tense. It is still a past simple tense. You have interchanged the subject in place of object and object in place of subject. And if you ask the question, who did the action? Who is the doer of the action? The boy. It has remained the same, okay? Despite being the object now, the boy is now the object. It is still the doer of the action. And that is how you have a passive voice. Fine. Now, we will take another example. The women were cooking food. Students, as you can see that it is a past continuous tense. So again, we will follow the same steps. We will ask the question, who is doing the action? And who is the doer of the action? The woman. Here you can see who is doing the action? The woman. So the woman will be the subject. And the woman, what is the action of woman? Cooking. So cooking is the verb here. What the woman cooking? Food. So food will be object here. Now, we will change the object in place of subject and subject in place of object. So here, the object will be the subject, the food, and the subject, the woman, the food by the woman. Okay, now we will see the main verb. Main verb is cooking. So students, I have already told you to use the third form of the verb in passive voice. So here, cook, cooked, cooked. We will write cooked. The food cooked by the woman. Now we will see the supporting verb. So students, you can see here it is in past continuous tense. So we will take the rules of the follow the rules of the past continuous tense, and we will add being, because being shows the continuous form of the verb. It shows that the work is going on. So we will use being, the food being cooked by the woman. After this, we will see the object here, which has become subject, the food. It is in singular form. So we use was. The food was being cooked by the woman. Okay. Now students, you saw that this sentence, you have interchanged the object in place of subject and subject in place of object. But it is still the doer of the action, the woman. So you have maintained the verb. It is still in the past continuous tense. Okay. Students, now let's have a look on our next example. Okay. Let's do it. Rina had given me a gift. Here, we again see that who is doing the action? Rina is doing the action. So, Rina is here subject. What is the action done by Rina? Had given. So, had given will be the verb. Now we will see what is the object here. A gift. Is Rina done action on gift? Do you think so? Students, ask the question. Who is doing the action? Rina. Okay. Now what is the action? Had given. So had given will be the verb. Is she given a gift to me? Or she had given something to gift? So action is done upon me. And definitely me is the object here, because I am the receiver of the action. Okay. Students, again I tell you, a lot of people will assume here gift to be the object. Okay. Because probably it is the last word in the sentence. It is not like that. Whenever you are confused, ask the question, okay, whom is the action done? So, me is the subject, me is the object here. And me becomes I in the subject in the passive voice. So we will put I, and then by Rina. We will put subject by Rina in place of object. Okay. Now we will see the main verb. Main verb is given. It is already in the third form. So we will write here given. And now we will see supporting verb. This is had given. So we will add, to make it in the past perfect tense, we will add been, had been, according to the rule of the past perfect tense. I had been given. What I had been given? A gift by Rina. Okay. Here, a gift is an indirect object. Okay. So, we will write here a gift. Don't play with the other parts of the sentence. Okay. Now, your sentence is completed. I had been given a gift by Rina. Okay. So, this is how you have done a past perfect passive voice. Okay. That is the end of the passive voice in past tense. I hope you enjoyed it watching. I will be back soon with the new lesson. Till then, take care.